you know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like
سلام. با یه قسمت دیگه از سری مستندهای بررسی شایعات پیرامون مایکل جکسون در خدمت شما هستیم. در این قسمت قصد داریم به بررسی مسئله تغییر رنگ پوست مایکل جکسون بپردازیم. خیلی از مردم فکر میکنن مایکل جکسون از اینکه سیاه‌پوست بود خوشش نمیومد و دلش میخواست سفیدپوست باشه. بر همین با عمل جراحی رنگ پوستش رو عوض کرد. بعضی دیگه هم فکر میکنن که چون مایکل میخواست نشون بده سیاه‌پوست یا سفیدپوست بودن فرقی نداره و همه با هم برابرند خودش رو سفید کرد. شایعات متعددی در این زمینه وجود داره که البته هیچ کدومشون حقیقت ندارن. حقیقت اینه که مایکل جکسون هیچ عمل زیبایی و هیچ جراحی برای سفید شدن پوستش انجام نداد. رنگ پوست اون ناخواسته تغییر پیدا کرد. مایکل جکسون از یک بیماری پوستی نادر به نام ویتیلایگو رنج می‌برد که حدود 2% از مردم جهان به اون مبتلا هستند. این بیماری در ایران بیشتر با نام‌های پیسی، برص یا لکوپیس شناخته میشه. مایکل این بیماری رو از پدر بزرگ پدریش به ارث برده بود. همونطور که داخل عکس میبینید، لکه‌های ویتیلایگو روی صورت پدر بزرگ مایکل به راحتی قابل تشخیصه. این بیماری یک اختلال تولید رنگدانه است که باعث میشه سلول‌های تولید کننده رنگدانه پوست تخریب بشن و دیگه رنگدانه تولید نکنن. به همین دلیل قسمت‌هایی از پوست بدن که رنگدانه خودشون رو از دست دادن سفید میشن. البته بهتر بگیم بی‌رنگ میشن چون دیگه رنگی ندارن. این بیماری باعث شد تا پوست مایکل جکسون در برابر آفتاب حساس بشه. تابش نور خورشید باعث سوزش پوست اون شد. به همین دلیل مجبور بود برای جلوگیری از تابش مستقیم آفتاب به پوستش از ماسک، چتر، کلاه و عینک آفتابی استفاده کنه. از طرفی ابتلا به بیماری لوپوس هم باعث حساس‌تر شدن پوست مایکل شده بود. او برای اولین بار در سال 1993 میلادی در مصاحبه زنده با اوپرا وینفری مشکل بیماری پوستیش رو بیان کرد. اما از اونجا که در اون زمان این بیماری زیاد شناخته شده نبود، دلیل تغییر رنگ پوست مایکل برای خیلی از مردم قابل درک نبود. در ادامه بخشی از این مصاحبه رو می‌بینید.
The thing that is most discussed about you, I think, is the fact that the color of your skin is obviously different than it was when you were younger.
Yes.
And so it has caused a great deal of speculation and controversy as to what you have done or are doing. Are you bleaching your skin? And is your skin lighter because you don't like being black?
Okay, number one, there, as I know of, there is no such thing as skin bleaching.
Mm-hmm.
I have never seen it. I don't know what it is.
Well, they used to have those products growing up. I used to hear, always use bleach and glow, but you'd have to have about 300,000 gallons.
Okay, number one, this is the situation. Yes. I have a skin disorder that destroys the pigmentation of the skin. It's something that I cannot help, okay? But when people make up stories that I don't want to be who I am, it hurts me.
So it is?
It's a problem for me, okay? I can't control it. Mm-hmm. Okay, but what about all the millions of people? Let's reverse it.
Okay.
What about all the millions of people who sit out in the sun to become darker, to become other than what they are? Mm-hmm. Nobody says nothing about that.
So when did this start? When did the color of your skin start to change?
Oh boy, sometime after Thriller, around Off the Wall Thriller.
And what did you think? I mean,
it's in my family. My father said it's on his side. I can't control it. I don't understand. I mean, it makes me very sad. I don't want to go into my medical history because that's something that's private. But that's the situation here. So please, when people see something like that.
I just want to get this straight. Yeah. You are not taking anything to change the color of your skin.
Oh God, no.
You did not purposely.
We're trying to control it, and using makeup evens it out because it makes blotches on the skin, and I have to even out my skin. I'm a black American. I'm proud to be a black American. I am proud of my race.
بیماری ویتیلایگو راه درمان قطعی نداره و مبتلایان به این بیماری ناچارن برای یکسان کردن رنگ پوستشون به لوازم آرایشی رو بیارن. مایکل هم از همین روش برای پوشوندن لکه‌های پوستش استفاده می‌کرد. این بیماری در بعضی مبتلایان پیشرفت نمی‌کنه، اما در بعضی دیگه پیشرفت می‌کنه که این پیشرفت می‌تونه به آهستگی یا سریع رخ بده. مایکل جکسون جزو دسته سوم مبتلایان بود، یعنی بیماریش پیشرفت می‌کرد و لکه‌های سفید به سرعت گسترش پیدا می‌کردن. تا زمانی که لکه‌های سفید زیاد نبودن، اون‌ها رو با استفاده از گریم و آرایش همرنگ بقیه پوستش می‌کرد. اما بعد از گسترش بیماری و افزایش چشمگیر لکه‌ها دیگه نمیتونست بیشتر پوستش رو به خاطر قسمت‌های کمی که هنوز سیاه مونده بودن گیریم کنه. پس از این به بعد ناچار بود قسمت‌های سیاه رو هم رنگ بقیه پوستش کنه. بعد از کشته شدن مایکل هم پزشکان کالبوت شکافی ابتلای او به ویتیلایگو رو تایید کردند. برای درک بهتر این مطلب دو نفر دیگه از مبتلایان به این بیماری رو بهتون معرفی میکنم. نفر اول لی توماس، اخبارگوی آمریکایی که برای حضور در جلوی دوربین مجبور با گریم لکه‌های بیماری رو بپوشونه.
Makeup so I can go to work today. Takes me about 15 minutes to put it on. But you start off with the vitiligo areas first. And then you blend the rest in. So I'm like about 40% without pigment now. Could get much worse. One day I may stop wearing dark makeup and flip it to light makeup. So I'm not really wanting to go down that route. I hope that doesn't happen. And there it is.
Why don't you turn your head and look toward the camera? You want to take a look at some of these?
Sure.
Look at how much he has here in 2007.
So that's 07 back.
To 2009.
Wow.
Really, wow. Two-thirds of it, really. Here's some chest.
Look at that. How much would you say? What percentage is gone? I said around 35 or 40%.
It's 55? A lot. Yeah.
More than 50?
Yeah.
Maybe 55% gone? 60?
Yeah.
It's gotten worse before it's gotten better.
نفر دوم دختری 23 ساله که بیماریش از 5 سالگی شروع به پیشرفت کرد.
Now to vitiligo, a skin condition you may not have heard of. It may be something you may not know much about. Michael Jackson claimed he suffered from it. To explain why his skin color became lighter over the years, well, 23-year-old Arcel Devlut began to show signs at the age of 5, and for the past 7 years, her skin has gone completely white, and now she's here along with dermatologist Dr. Janine Downey to talk about this. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Let's talk first of all, Arcel, talk about what happened with you, because you're saying it started with your arms and your legs when you were young, and then at age 12 what happened?
Well, I got a spot on my arm at the age of 5. That's the first sign of it, and then one on my forehead, and from the ages of 5 to 12 it slowly was going through my arms and legs and on my torso, and then by the time I reached 12 years old it just started spreading very rapidly onto my face, my neck and face.
How do people get this condition?
Okay, we're not sure exactly. Vitiligo affects 3% of the population, and you see it in all races and all ethnicities. Obviously, it's more noticeable in people with darker complexions. The bottom line is we think it's genetic. Most people have either primary or secondary relatives, 25% to 30% of people that have vitiligo that actually have, you know, vitiligo in their families as well.
Is there any other secondary effect besides your skin changing color?
Well, you're more sensitive to the sun, and so people with vitiligo tend to blister and burn more, and they can have more skin cancers.
Okay, so that's a big issue, but yeah. Be anything else besides that?
It's disfiguring. People think that it's contagious. People make people feel badly about it. So it's very psychologically devastating.
So you, having gone through all of this and being, I'm sure, a young woman who listened to Michael Jackson's did you feel that he had, did you have any, based on your experience, do you think that Michael Jackson did have this skin condition?
At the time when I was living in Cyprus and I knew nobody with the condition, we didn't know what it was, we had no experience of it, and there was no one out there except for Michael Jackson who was saying that they had it. And in a way, that sort of was a support from myself. So I would absolutely want to believe that, yes, he had it. And I think there's a lot of evidence to back it up.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't see why anybody should not believe that.
A lot of people did make fun of Michael Jackson's skin changing color. So you sort of empathize with him and feel that.
Definitely.
با وجود این همه مدارک و شواهد و گذشت 22 سال از مشخص شدن دلیل تغییر رنگ پوست مایکل جکسون، دیگه واقعا خنده‌دار اگه هنوز کسی فکر کنه که مایکل جکسون با اعمال جراحی و به خواست خودش سفید شد. جای تأسف داره که پیج‌های فیسبوکی همچنان به انتشار این دروغ‌ها ادامه میدن و سریال هایی مثل سریال شاهگوش ساخته میشن که حاوی چنین دیالوگ هایی هست.
ما میدونم دیگه ایران شما مشکل شما با این خارخاره روی صورت منه، ولی اینا همش با حال جرایی درست میشه. یه خواننده ای هست اون برای افتان برو ببین، مایکل جکسون، این سیاه پوست بود با حال جرایی الان سفید پوست شده.
خواهش من از شما اینه که این ویدیو رو به اشتراک بذارین تا افراد دیگه که هنوز واقعیت رو نمیدونن آگاه بشن. برای ساخت این مستند ساعت‌ها وقت صرف شده. سهم شما در انتشار حقیقت یک کلیک ساده بر روی گزینه شیر در عرض چند ثانیه است. برای دیدن ویدیوهای بیشتر میتونید در فیسبوک یا یوتیوب ما رو دنبال کنید.
Are you very spiritual?
In what sense?
I mean, do you meditate? Do you understand that there is something bigger than yourself at work here?
I believe in God, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Very much.